In the Dumbo Neural Cartography project, we're bringing together low-cost brain-computer interfaces, public participation, and a suite of tools to record and project mental activity back onto the city. These are some of the first interactive maps of mental phenomenon at the urban scale. Dumbo, our test site, is a city in a microcosm. In three square blocks, you can find an extreme variety of environments, from mixed-use housing and parks to immense pieces of infrastructure. A group of participants recorded their mental impressions as they walked a series of pathways through the site. Each participant's brainwaves were recorded along with their location and heading to relate what they were experiencing with what they were seeing. In the simplest case of a single walk, we can see how the participant moves through the city and even corresponding shifts in the dominance of meditation and attention. It's important to note that these values are very subjective, different people experiencing things differently, and the brainwaves only let us infer mental states. We're examining several tendencies we saw in the initial data. Attention seemed to spike at intersections, sometimes showing up as a crosshair in the visualization. The block structure itself seemed to encourage a meditative quality in general. We also noted high levels of attention spiking whenever our participants were placed into ambiguous situations, such as entering a park or into a walkable square. How does the shape, organization, or other characteristics of a city sculpt our mental experience? Do parks and other green zones provide a meditative space, or actually activate us mentally, perhaps as we encounter and process a more complicated set of possibilities? Does the simplicity of the street grid help us to achieve a flow state, or otherwise free up attention for other tasks? The Cloud Lab will be following up on these questions and more in further neural cartography projects.